Welcome back to the channel. Today we want to tackle the AC box, AC from Vintage Air. We're working on the Frankenstein. I started putting the glass in. We ran out of parts. We're missing some parts, hardware, stuff like that, and it's on order. So we got to get something else on the list done. So let's work on this AC. I'm not going to waste too much of your time today. We're just going to get straight to it. What's up, y'all? Echo, pause. So, you're probably, what the hell am I doing? Why am I drilling holes, right? Well, like you guys saw the firewall is already smoothed out. And we should have left these bolts exposed for this bracket for the AC box under here. Or we should have created something that would have held it here prior us putting this in before we got that thing smoothed out. This is what happens when you want to put AC in the car after you're like, nah, I'm not going to run AC. But now we want to run AC because it's 115 out here in Vegas. So what I'm doing here real quick, I got that one drilled out. We'll make sure this bracket is nice and level because this will bolt up to the actual unit, the AC unit. Now I know the stock factory hole goes right there. That's kind of where I was grinding it off because I can actually see where it was filled in. And I've already positioned this one time, marked it with the box here, because it'll also guide up here, just bolt up here to go there. So what I'm gonna do there, once I got that hole drilled out, take my level and make sure so we can drill this top hole out. So we're nice and level. See right there, right dead center of the hole. Okay, right there. All right, let's drill. Okay, so before we put this bracket on, we're gonna go ahead and throw these on real quick, these little hose extensions that go here. It should be in your kit, it should look something like that. Just the hose extension with the barb fitting on it. We're gonna apply some, just a little bit of lube here on the O-ring here. So just use any assembly lube you might have. Just, they usually send it to you in a kit. I didn't see it in there today. I've seen other kits where I do get it. I've seen kits where they're not in it. This one did not. Just go ahead and screw those on. Grab a couple crescent wrenches and tighten these up. But try to get as much as you can stuff on this assembly box, this heater box, AC box, that you can before you put it in the car. So that way you're not struggling trying to put this thing on or put the stuff on later. Also, when you're taking those caps off that cover these, be careful because this thing is pressurized and you will just, air will just pop out of there like really loud. So it might scare you. Just take it easy. Take precaution. You guys can see. Caution. But let me finish this up, putting the rest of the stuff on, and then we'll get to the car. This is usually what your heater hoses, AC lines are going to run through. The majority of the time, but since you know our firewall basically got smoothed out and everything else like that, we're gonna end up just, because this huge hole is gone, this huge hole is usually there from your like factory blower motor, heater box, whatever you guys AC, usually blower motor sits there. But so Vintage Air gives you this guy here to put that in with grommets and run your hoses through it. But our hole is gone. So what I'm going to do is going to use this guy here and re-drill just these here and not re-drill this huge, enormous hole. And so we're just going to drill the actual ones for the actual hoses themselves. It's just a 3/8 hole saw. We'll do that. And usually I'm gonna do it right here in the corner of the fender here. Alright, so that's kind of what our firewall looks like right now. And you see this little hole. I've already made this little hole kind of to give us a center where the other four holes are gonna go. So what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna use this as a template just like that. And we will mark these four like that so we have them nice and evenly squared, and then drill these out. Let me go ahead and mark these and we'll get started. Oh boy, it got messy quick, huh? Okay, son of a gun. See this shite? That's not what I had in mind. You see that? That's why I pre-drilled that small pilot hole right in the middle of it. So that way that hole saw wouldn't bounce around too bad. But it, the first one we did, it sure enough, that's exactly what happened. It bounced around and that happened, but we'll put the grommets in here. We'll probably clean this up real quick just with a little file. And then we'll throw the grommets in there and then call it a day. Or not call it a day, but at least run the hose through there. Let's do that real quick. Alright, you guys, those grommets were a pain in the ass, right? I think they were harder to get the grommets in than it was drilling the holes out. But you guys get the picture. You're probably wondering, I probably could have used a screwdriver to get these in a little better, but the last thing I wanted to do is risk that screwdriver slipping, and guess what? Another scratch somewhere or whatever with the freshly painted firewall. But we'll run our hoses through here. And then push them out, throw the cow on this side or on the inside, and then there's another little plate that you're going to need to adapt to the cow, where with four holes just like this you'll see in your guys' kit, and we'll run the hoses out through there as well. But I'm almost positive that you have to push these hoses out from the inside. Let's do that here. Let's see. We got our little cushion here, so it don't hurt too bad. All right, so this is kind of how I got the box set up right now. You want to make sure you got this little L bracket here that should bolt up to your stock bracket here off your dash. And then you want to make sure you had the bracket on the back of the actual box, the actual AC unit itself. You bolt that on with the four bolts that it comes with. I'm not going to go over that. That should be pretty self-explanatory. If not, check the instructions. You guys will see what I'm talking about. I might even show you once I pull this thing off. What's up, guys? It's hot. Made a little bracket. Underneath the fender, I was getting ready to run the heater hoses, AC lines, and I noticed that, well, I'm probably not going to run the inner fender well, or might get some custom ones made later on, but I need something to hold these heater hoses up and maybe wiring and stuff like that. So this is kind of what I came up with. This is really all this is. Look, all this is this plate. Literally, it's like the dividers that divide up in the toolbox. All I did was cut it down the middle and then split it, and it made two out of one. You guys can see it made two out of one. So, and then drill some holes on it, but made some angles, about an inch on each side. So if you picture this, this will be underneath the fender on each side. I'll put two on each side. So that way, I'll bolt this side to the fender itself from the inside that way. And the heater hoses and lines and anything else I might want to run and tuck underneath there will actually lay in here. And so they don't droop down or fall down. And then we'll figure out the routing from there. But I also put this piece of, I want to say it's just an inch and a half. I had some heat shrink just to kind of protect it, because this thing, after you cut it, it's kind of sharp. So I just put this there. I mean, I think it'll work. It should be good. I'll bolt this up to the inside of the fender. We'll go from there. Let me know what y'all think about this idea. There ain't no rules in building cars, right? All right. Is my hair messed up? Yeah. Also, I got to run to the store real quick. I was going to run the lines. Remember talking about heater and AC? Vintage Air does not give you the lines. The heater lines. That's messed up. This kit is almost, what, $1,500? And they don't even give you some heater hose? So now I got to run AutoZone and get some heater hose. You're right there. Motion detected at the front door. Alright everyone, so I had to put the camera down. I had to move the camera because you guys saw me and was trying to be a contortionist and all that. I went ahead and finally got the bolts in. It wasn't easy. I've done it. I should have probably just done it the way I used to do it. Is where basically get this box up here, bolt it in, down at the bottom as well. And then put these AC lines on. The AC lines are really the ones that are having a difficult time trying to get that one here. This big one, it really fights you because it puts a nice resistance on you to try to get that on. But we got it on. So, and then obviously this guy will fall in there. Also, your plate here where it runs through the cow duct there. And then I went ahead. When you put the bolts through the firewall, you're going to need two people. I had to get one of my girls, one of my 8-year-olds, to come over and help me and hold one side while I torque or screw down the other side on the firewall side. You see? It's impossible because the bolt's just going to keep spinning, and you'll never be able to screw it on, get it tight, whatever you want to do. I didn't want these bolts out here, but my plan is to actually utilize them. You guys can see these are the ones they provide you, and I'm going to end up probably hanging stuff off of them, like a catch can, maybe even my distributor packs and stuff like that. Distributor packs, coil packs. I'll hang coil packs off and stuff like that, so they won't just look like an eyesore. They'll actually be put to use. And then I wanted to show you guys, remember those brackets I hooked up here? So that's what it should look like coming through. And then I went ahead and actually put the valve in, your heater valve there. Make sure it goes into the 5/8 hose. That's the one that's got to go into. And a lot of people have this stuff, they confuse this thing a lot on these LS engines real quick. So there's your water pump, right? Small guy. 5/8. That's the one that's got to come, actually. That's your out of your water pump. The big boy, the 3/4 inch, is your back, is your return. So just keep that in mind. But what I did, though, remember those little brackets we fabbed up? See how they kind of worked out for us? See how they kind of hold the hoses in place in the fender in there? Nice and tucked. We could run wire and stuff like that. I went and put that hello caution tape there so you guys can see it when I was showing you guys. So let me see if I can. Oh, this, sorry guys, it got dark. It got late quick between me fabbing these things up, running the AutoZone, so it got late. But that's how it kind of my idea was to hide those hoses and everything else. Let me show you the engine side real quick so you can see how I bolted them to the fender. You can use whatever hardware you want. I just drilled two holes here, two on each side. I'm probably going to just paint those black, touch them up black or whatever, so they just kind of blend in a little bit more. Just leave them. We'll see. But more or less, we'll do the same thing to the other side for wire management and stuff like that. We'll put it on that side. But look at this. I mean, I know the lighting sucks, guys. But look, you can't even see those hoses in there, you know? And then they come down here. They'll drop and then hook them up wherever you need to hook them up. And then you can route them and stuff like that. But we'll just end the video here, guys. It's late, super late, tired. I gotta get these kids. They wanted to be bugging me all day. They want to go see a movie and stuff like that. So I'm gonna go take them for them helping me out work on this thing. But hopefully this information helps anybody out there putting the AC set up and these old Chevelles, old muscle cars, things like that. Let me know if you guys have any questions. Put them down in the comments below. Hit the thumbs up, and subscribe. Don't forget to subscribe. Appreciate it.